The Do More engine has a comprehensive set of file I/O instructions which you can use to get pretty creative with your data logging. But most of the time, you just want to issue a log with as little effort as possible, right? Well, if so, this video is for you. You can skip all this stuff and just grab this one instruction, file log. Let's send the log to the SD card. We'll use short string 0 for the file name. Let's add a log entry once a second, and let's append a timestamp to the file name. For each log entry, let's send a string, the contents of D0, another string, and the contents of WX0. Well, that looks good. Let's add an always-on contact, accept the changes, and send this to the Do More PLC. I'll bring up a data view so we can put a file name in short string 0, some text in string 1, and some more text in string 2. And write all those changes to the PLC. Great. Flip the switch to run mode, wait a couple seconds to get some log entries, which should be coming at 1 per second, and then open up the file browser. We want to look at the SD card where we sent the log, and sure enough, there's the new log we just created. If I rebrowse to update the screen, you can see the timestamp changing. Exactly what we expect. That's all there is to creating a log. Now before we go back to dig a little deeper into the instruction, let's take a look at this file browser. You can copy a file from your host computer to the PLC, copy a selected file from the PLC to the computer, delete a file, or even create a folder. All the things you would normally expect. You can sort on any column, drop down into any folder, and even show hidden files. This tells you at a glance all about your storage space for both the SD card and the built-in RAM drive. Browse to root refreshes the view and quickly gets you to the root folder. That's great if you're buried down several layers of folders and just want to get back to the top level quickly. Refresh updates this list if you insert an SD card while the dialog's up. This is for formatting the RAM drive. You can't format the SD card here because it would take forever on the PLC. So for SD cards, just format them on your computer before using them here on the PLC. You can also mount and dismount the SD card. Well, what does that mean? Well, when you insert or remove an SD card from the BRX PLC, it automatically recognizes the SD card and opens it up for use or closes it for removal. It's kind of like when you put a USB memory stick into your computer. You're supposed to eject it before removing it, right? Same thing. It just makes sure all the loose ends are tied off before ejecting the SD card. But we said the BRX automatically does this, right? So why do we need this? Well, oftentimes, we'll build a system in an enclosure, and we really don't want the end users opening the box for any reason, much less to extract the memory card. So what do? Well, we add an extension cord so folks can access the memory card without opening the box. The problem with that is when you remove a card from the slot in the PLC, there's a mechanical switch that closes to tell the BRX PLC it's been removed. If you have an extension cable plugged in, the switch contact never happens and the BRX has no way of knowing the card was removed, which means the card is never cleanly dismounted and you run the risk of getting corrupt data on the card. The way around that is to provide this mount and dismount ability. Simply bring up this file browser and dismount the SD card before removing the card from the extension cable. Likewise, when you plug the card in, hit mount to tell the BRX the new card has been inserted. Could you connect an HMI and have a button on it to mount and dismount the SD card? Sure. Just use the file system command in your ladder code to format, mount, or dismount the SD card. Note that it's fully asynchronous. You just hit it with a rising edge, usually the HMI button press for example, and then wait for it to tell you it's done so you can tell the user it's safe to remove the SD card. Whether you're using an extension cable or not, please make sure you're not writing to the SD card when you remove it from the PLC. Okay, enough file browser stuff. Let's take a closer look at the file log instruction. We can choose to write to the SD card or the RAM drive that's built into the BRX PLC. But wait a minute. The legacy Do More platforms don't have SD cards or RAM drives. Does this work on those PLCs? Well, yeah, it does. When you update the firmware, the legacy platforms will now have a RAM drive, and you can use the new email instruction to send that log wherever you want. How about that? You can type in a file name here. Be sure to put it in double quotes. I prefer to use a string variable so I can change it programmatically whenever I want. Can you change the file name while the program's running? Sure. Our last example is still running, so let's change the file name. wait a second or two, and bring up the file browser. We want the SD card, and sure enough, the new file is now being updated. Cool. We've been triggering our log based on a specific time period, but you can also trigger on any event. When you select that option, it just adds an edge-triggered input to the instruction, so you can trigger on anything you want. Undo that, and now it just logs periodically as long as the power is applied. You've already seen the file name timestamp. That was this guy in our previous example. That's really handy. This generated file name is cool. Suppose you have things set up to periodically log messages, and you want to email a copy of the current log. How do you know what the file name is? It keeps changing because that file name timestamp keeps getting updated. Well, if you check this box, the last used file name will always appear in whatever string variable you put here. So you just give this string variable to the email instruction, which we'll cover in a separate video, and you're done. You never have to worry about what the current file name is. Once again, Do More makes things so easy. You've already seen how easy it is to use this table. Just put whatever you want to log in here. Easy. The count is simply how many consecutive elements you want to send. If we wanted to log D0 through D4, we would have put a 5 here. You are limited to a maximum of 10 consecutive elements per row of this table. And you can insert a row and remove a row and move rows up and down. Very easy to work with. This instruction works great in a staged program, which I personally prefer because it's so easy, but you can also do your own interlocking using the CBITs if that's your preference. Well, that ought to be enough to get you up and running with basic data logging. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of automation professionals there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.